that?
We need to find a way to move forward. But frankly, I'm having trouble figuring out how.
Climbing the wall.
Do you have mountaineering training?
I'm a spec ops soldier, not some city wuss riding a desk. I've got all kinds of training.
I must admit, I'm quite glad to hear that.
Shit. You again?
Careful. There's a gap up ahead.
I see it.
You've got quick reflexes, Major.
You bet. I wouldn't survive without him. Charles, that was a Barov, right? A tunneling robot.
Indeed it was. Barovs can drill through even the hardest minerals at incredible speed. Soviet science has high hopes for them in regard to our inevitable conquest of all the planets in the solar system.
Thank you.
took such good care of those wonderful, powerful, brilliantly designed machines. And now, oh, the irony.
What are you talking about?
The Buravs, our finest product. What a shame. Did you know we weren't allowed to sell them abroad, Comrade?
Worked on the Buravs?
From day one. Built just about everything in here. Used to be. No artificial sea, no fields, no forests or anything here. To say nothing of the cable cars. Just mountain ranges. No, hardly anyone stops to think about what it used to be like here. And it's all thanks to my Buravs. We moved mountains. Built the whole infrastructure. They're tearing down what they built. They've got no idea. A machine's mind is like a small child's, you know. It needs love, care, or it'll descend into confusion. The irony, Comrade. I took such good care of those wonderful, powerful, brilliantly designed machines. And now, oh, the irony.
What are you talking about?
The Buravs, our finest product.
Why is there a ban on exporting them?
They're cutting-edge city-building machinery, that's why. Point them at the ground, and in a month, you'll have a complete subway system, or any sort of tunnel. Subway is hell. It's the moon they were going to use them for, terraforming. So they're top secret and their armor is tougher than a tank's. PTA plates, unmarked. Cutting edge science.
What's so ironic about that?
Oh, it's ridiculous, really. I was a roboticist here, you see. I was a Burav roboticist. When I heard the robots were attacking people, I rushed here. Wanted to switch mine off. So they chopped me up. I was killed by my own machines. The control panels got buried under the rubble. Now they're on their own, digging God knows what. Like they're sleepwalking or something. I wonder what they're dreaming of without us.
Sorry, I gotta run.
Sure, yeah, okay.
Man, do I ever love crawling through dark-ass tunnels. That was a fucking hell of a ride.
Under ordinary circumstances, the cable car network links all the underground sectors of Facility 3826. It should be easier next time.
Thanks, bud. I think I'll just hoof it on the surface. This is my stop. What a nice trip. A laser wall. That's some serious security. People put them up for a reason. If you see one, that means there's something important on the other side.
Quite right, Comrade Major. The distribution center we're looking for is, in fact, on the other side.
There's no way I'm making it through a laser wall in one piece.
There's a repair vendor up ahead. Try upgrading your equipment to increase your laser resistance.
Not a pervy lunatic fridge. Thank you.
You're back! What took you so long? I was so lonely.
Uh-huh. Look, I need to go through a laser wall, preferably alive.
What a silly idea, honey. That's awful risky. You should stay with me instead. I'll do whatever you want.
Ugh, just give me laser protection!
Oh, so brutal. I'm shaking. Squirt your polymer inside me.
Don't let her boss you around. We have no time to waste.
Don't listen to him, big guy. He wants to drive us apart. Take off that stupid glove so we can stay together forever.
I see. Do you want me to punch you or tear you apart?
You'd really kill me over a stupid glove, sugar? How would you survive in this cruel, violent world without me?
Easily. It's not like you're actually helping me or anything.
But I can't make things for you out of thin air, sugar. I need polymer and other components to work. Put your polymer inside me so I can pleasure you.
I get it. You'll get your polymer and your precious components. Just install the laser protection already.
Whatever you say, Stud. Upgrade initiated. Relax and enjoy. Just promise you'll talk dirty to me again.
I am so gonna punch you.
Yes, yes! Punish me, Master! I love dominant males.
Oh, gross.
Your defense system is active. Try to run through the laser wall.
After that creepy shit, I'd be willing to run through any wall. That hurt! That thing packs a punch. I almost bought the farm there.
The key word being... almost.
You got that right. Let's go find that traitor. When I get my hands on him, I'm gonna rip his fucking head off. I mean... I'm gonna rip something off. Damn it!
Don't worry, honey. I'm right as rain. The operation was totally painless.
Good. You need to leave right now. There's a man coming for you. He's armed and wearing an experimental polymer glove.
Must be Sechenov's guy. Larissa, did you talk to him?
He was attacked by a Burav. We took him to the infirmary and then... I didn't know. I couldn't just let him bleed out.
Well, you should have. It would have saved us a whole lot of trouble.
It scares me.
me when you talk like that.
I'll meet you at the exit. I'm right behind you, honey. I just hope we're not too late.
Hope can be dangerous. Hands up!
Victor?
What's going on?
You deaf? Hands behind your head.
Victor!
The hell
Victor?
Are you?
Major Nechaya Special Operations, and that's the last question you get. You're going to Chelemei.
Victor, save yourself!
Chelemei. Of course, Comrade Major. Intrusion.
Huh?
Intrusion!
Warning.
Hey, freeze!
Warning.
Damn it.
Red alert. Lockdown in progress.
Thank you.
pretty good at ordering those robots around. It's almost like they're his property. Lock the goddamn door.
Petrov ran off with the mobile. Petrov ran off with the mobile power source called the cannon. It powers the emergency lock.
Thank you.
He's pretty good at ordering those robots around. It's almost like they're his property. And he locked the goddamn door.
Petrov ran off with a mobile power source called the Canyon. It powers the emergency lockdown.
Praise the Tin God.
Petrov ran off with a mobile power source called the Candle. It powers the emergency lockdown system. This door cannot be opened without a candle.
I'll find another one. There's got to be more than one candle in this complex, right?
We need to hurry. Otherwise, Petrov will escape the sector and we'll have to track him down again.
Is adorned with a PEG-4 birch tree, the symbol of the Vavilov complex and the capstone of its research efforts. Thanks to the power of the polymers and the joint effort of the complex's many workshops, this tree can thrive in a wide range of climates while simultaneously purifying the surrounding air. It can also produce electricity. To demonstrate this...
Charles, what's that birch tree encased in glass in the room down there? Is it the famous PEC-4 power generator?
Indeed it is. The Birchtree PEC-4 is a vegetative polymer-based power generator. It's an experimental model. The first step of our program to conquer the distant planets of the solar system.
Attention all co-workers. Please listen to this chirper and leave it where it is. Its purpose is to remind everyone not to take plant specimens home under any circumstances, including seemingly harmless ones. Flowers from the labs may have built-in genetic traits that will have a negative effect on your quality of life. If it's grown in a lab, it stays in a lab. Period.
Scared of what? The robots?
No! Robots kill quickly and simply, but they...
His lingering polymer memory is exhausted, Comrade Major.
Got it. People here are getting killed by stuff other than robots. But what?
I cannot ascertain. But I'd be lying if I said we'll never find out.
Understood.
They're in the wall! Can you hear them? Scurrying around!
You've got nothing to be scared of. You're... dead.
I know! Even back when I was alive, I saw dead people get up again. I don't want this to happen to me. I'm scared of them.
I gotta keep moving.
Keep your eyes peeled. They're even tormenting the dead. I've seen it. I've seen it.
I always have to carry it like this.
The candle is a complex, unstable piece of equipment. It cannot be stowed in your backpack along with your other items. There is a high probability of mutual destructuralization.
Like an explosion?
Not necessarily, but the candle would be disabled.
So I'll have to carry it like this. Got it.
The candle is quite durable. You can drop it or even throw it intentionally. Nothing will happen to it.
Mm-hmm.
So, you think you're smarter than your bosses?
No, you're twisting my words, Doc. I never said I was smarter than them.
But you said...
No, I said that if I had the same opportunities and resources they do, I'd accomplish just as much as they have, if not more.
Do you envy people like Sechenov, Lebedev, Filimonenko?
Envy isn't really the right word. Envy is when you want what someone else has. I don't want what anyone else has. I want to be right there with them. I want to be their equal. And I'm not talking about their discretionary authority. I want us all to be genuinely equal. But that's enough. We've talked about this 100 times and you still don't believe me. This is a waste of time. Guard, we're done here.
Those loaders are going nuts. Is this Petrov's doing?
Be careful. Loaders are extremely durable. You won't be able to damage them with a simple axe.
Shock therapy usually works pretty well on nutcases, metallic or otherwise.
Thank you.
Sounds like Petrov's voice. I hope that asshole's brains didn't get splattered all over the floor.
We need Petrov alive. Hurry, Major.
What the fuck does it look like I'm doing?
It looks like there was a containment breach in the algae workshop, and experimental materials leaked out.
That's actually good for us.
punishable by capital punishment.
Thank you.
This is the Luna, a kind of lock.
It'll open once all the holes have canisters of lunar soil in them. You eggheads sure love your fancy locks, don't you? Guess I'll go find some canisters.
I stopped by the archive yesterday, and everything there is so automated. We won't have to work at all pretty soon. We'll just sit there listening to music. Here's a peek. Robots can't appreciate it the way we do.
Thank you.
Well, what do we have here?
Experimental data must be kept secure at all times.
I've got one.
Thank you.
Not that batshit lady robot perv again. I'll go around her.
Not so fast, Comrade Major. I understand that interactions with this model may be unpleasant for you, but it would be prudent to see if she has anything we can use.
Fine. If I can get a good weapon out of her, I guess it'll be worth it.
There it is.
There you are, Sugar! Oh, I missed you so much. Have you dumped that stupid glove yet?
Don't count on it.
I love it when you get angry. Yes, yes! Scold me, punish me. I was a bad girl and strung up another disgusting creep.
What? You killed someone again? You monster.
But you haven't entered me for so long, big guy. I was so lonely. I had to blow off some steam.
Enough. Will this ever end?
Don't get flustered over such little things, Sugar. I made you a present. You're gonna like it. I promise.
I'd like to pull the plug on you, but it's too bad. That I can't do without your help.
I did my best.
This is cool. For real. Now, could you please not kill anyone else?
I just can't help myself. Hot stuff.
Well, just do your best, okay? Oh, this is fucking...
Remember that all experimental results are...
Where the hell is it?
Attention. All staff members who receive their notice are to report to social control by end of day. Failure to report will be considered an aggravating circumstance.
Charles, what does Petrov need with the repair vendor? Why would the sicko try to take control of Nora? Why would he even need weapons? He's got robots fighting for him.
The traitor realized that employees confronted with hostile robots will defend themselves. And the soldiers defending the facility will attempt to get more powerful weapons.
He must have been scared someone would bump into him by accident and shoot him like the traitorous piece of dog shit he is.
That very well may be. Regardless, Petrov was unable to get his hands on a repair vendor. However, Nora's algorithms were still corrupted in a most hideous manner.
That dirty son of a whore. The repair vendor is completely insane. He's got her saying all kinds of creepy sex shit and making goofy junk instead of decent weapons. And she kills people.
Does that mean we'll have to go unarmed?
Anything's better than nothing, right? I'd rather take on a robot with a metal toilet brush than my bare hands. Obviously, the last canister has to be lodged deep in the universe's quantum asshole. Does this stuff happen to everyone, or just me?
Thank you.
I've got another one. Done.
I think it worked.
Cities are soon to be erected. Similar samples were also collected from Mars.